Friends, another problem on continuity equation. So a pipeline is carrying an oil of specific gravity 0.8 changes in diameter from 300 millimeter at position 1 to 600 millimeter diameter at position 2. So which is 5 meter at a higher level. If the pressure at position 1 and 2 are 100 kilonewton per meter square and 60 kilonewton per meter square respectively, and the discharge is 300 liters per second, determine the loss of head and direction of flow. So the it is given that the discharge is 300 liters per second. So it is converted to meter cube per second. So as we know, so 1000 liters is 1 meter cube. So for 300 liters, it is 0.3 meter cube per second. So specific gravity of the oil is given as 0.8. It is given here. So weight of the oil is now, so specific gravity into G, so that is 9.81. So that is specific gravity is 0.8 into 9.81. So that is 7.85. So it is kilonewton per meter cube. So at position 1, so the diameter of the pipe, as we have seen in problem 1. So here also the diameter is changing from 300 millimeter diameter to 600 millimeter diameter. So the diameter is at the section 1, it is 300 millimeter, 0.3 meter. So area of the pipe is calculated here. So pressure at section 1 is also given. So that is 100 kilonewton per meter square. So then the datum line is passing through the section 1. So then the Z1 is equal to 0. So velocity V1 is equal to Q by A1. So velocity is now discharge, that is 0.3 meter cube per second by A1. So that is area of the pipe at the section is calculated, so that we are substituting here. So velocity is 4.24 meter per second at section 1. Now at position 2, so diameter of the pipe D2 is 600 millimeter, so that is 0.6 meter. So the difference between the problem 1, what we discussed earlier and now, is so where the diameter was bigger at section 1 and it is reduced to lower diameter at section 2 in the earlier problem, but now the diameter is increasing from D1 to diameter D2. So earlier section 1 is at the higher end and section 2 is at the lower end. Now so it is reverse. So section 1 is at the lower end and section 2 is at the higher end. So diameter, so based on the data given, you take the sections, so of as per your convenience. So diameter of the pipe D2 is this. So area of the pipe is calculated. Pressure is also given here at section 2 as 60 kilonewton per meter square. So that is what written here. So datum, so that is the height of the pipe, that is the axis of the pipe from the datum line at section 2 is at 5 meter. So velocity V2 is now Q by A2. So Q is 0.3 divided by A2. So we are getting velocity here. Now it is as in the question to find the loss of head and in which direction the flow is taking place. How to find the loss of the head? So now I have to consider the total energy at section 1. So which is the summation of the three heads, that is the pressure head plus kinetic head plus datum head. So pressure head is nothing but the ratio of P1 by rho g. So rho g is nothing but my weight density. So that we have calculated here. So that is 7.85. So that is what we have written here. So pressure at section 1 is 100, it is given. So we are substituting the values here. So velocity is calculated as 4.24 at section 1. We are substituting here by 2g plus z1. So that is 0 because the axis of the pipe is exactly on the datum line. So my z1 is 0. But when I take the section 2, it is given that the axis of the pipe is at a height of 5 meters. So in the place of z2, we are substituting z2 as 5. So here we are taking the sum of all the 3 heads, so which is coming as the total energy at section 1 as 13.66. Similarly, substituting everything in E2, that is the total energy at section 2, so that is 12.76 meters. So that is the energy of the flowing fluid at section 1 is 13.66. By the time it reaches the section 2, the energy of the flowing fluid is 12.76. Because of the change in the diameter, so there will be energy loss. How much of energy is lost now? So that is the difference of these two energies, that is E1 and E2. So that is 0.9 meter. So that is by the time the fluid flow takes place from section 1 to section 2, some of the energy possessed by the flowing fluid is lost because of the change in diameter. So how much energy is lost? So that is 0.9 meters. So the energy loss will be measured in terms of head. So now in which direction the flow is going to take place? Since energy is more at section 1 and energy is less at section 2, the flow is taking place from section 1 to section 2. Thank you.